What's good, y'all? I am very excited because today is the final episode of Quest 64, and it's probably only gonna last about 10 minutes. So I figured I'd get it out of the way. 12 hours and 44 minutes. All right. Let's see what we gotta do. Oh, we're in a town. Everything's locked. What the fuck? Okay, something's going on. This shit's bugged out or something. Can I go back in the house that this came out of? No, I can't. Something's bugged out. Hold on. Let me reset. In this game. I don't know what to do. I just want to finish this goddamn game. Back in the place I came out of. Hold on. Thank you.
I think that's it. I think the game is done. I can't do anything. There's something going on. Let me use one of these. No? To God, don't know. Let me reset one more time. I have no fucking clue. Come on. God damn it. Don't tell me. This fucking shitty ass broken game just ends here. There's nothing I can do. I'll be honest, I just looked at a walkthrough and it said I was supposed to come out in some weird, like, blue place. It didn't say anything about coming out into a town. I don't know. I'm not starting the game over, I know that much. Well, I guess that's it. Request 64. If anybody has any suggestions or anything, I'll come back and try to beat it. But, I'd love to beat it right now, but I can't. There's nothing I can do. I can't. can't go in any of these houses. I can't leave. I can't even go back in the fucking room I came out of. So, yeah. Here's what it says. Save the game and rest. Just keep going through doors until you find Shannon in a light room. Talk to her and hear some very interesting dialogue. In the end, she'll give you a dark key and you'll be teleported to Mammon. Go with the paths and Mammon will have a little talk with you and then you'll be in the final battle. It does not say anything about coming out into a town. I don't know. Well, that's it. Unless anybody has any suggestions, if anybody ever watches this, let me know. I tried everything. I feel like I'm in, somewhere I'm not supposed to be. There's gotta be something. Last thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna look up a YouTube video. Bear with me a second. Raise a toast to that. God, I hate fucking ads. Toasty crunchy chip. Ritz toasted chips. Silence back at the last.
represent something or not. A few of the rooms will have the same color scheme, and you can just throw them off. You can't go back through the doors that you have gone through previously, but that's just gonna set you back quite a ways. Now these guys, the Pale Riders, are pretty easy to defeat. They are winged though, so my wing attacks don't do a whole lot of damage. Avalanche, however, does huge damage. I recommend using that if you do want to fight against some of these guys. I mean, if you want to, you can get a few more, perhaps it's HP, a couple more MP, a little bit more agility, which may or may not help you when you come to the final boss. I'll fight a couple of enemies just for demonstration. There's a couple of them I do want to stay completely away from, however, because they're very strong. This enemy may be the exact example that I'm speaking of. These pinheads, they can do 60, 70, 80 damage per turn, which I am just completely 100% not interested in dealing with. However, the Pale Riders on the right, there's an enemy called Judgment, which is also very easy to defeat. It's like a big stone statue, and these guys aren't so bad either. The Spriggans, I like to attack them with wind. I pretty much like to attack everything with wind at this point in the game. I do believe that these guys are fine, and they have a silencing attack that we were seeing earlier with the nightmares back in the desert. So those are the only four varieties you'll see in here, with the pinhead being the most dangerous. There's a house similar to one in Limwood. There's nothing upstairs, so don't bother, just go back through the door. There are no spirits and no chests to collect here, so don't worry about missing anything, because there is nothing to collect. It's just a matter of going through this world and finally meeting up with an end. Now, if I'm in this room, the pillar behind me makes it an awful cavern to try and fight anything here. If I were to be fighting, it kind of gets in the way, and it makes it difficult for me to run away because I can't see what I'm doing, so I'm just gonna run away from these guys. I'm not even gonna run. At this point, I just want to be done with this game. I'm so close to the end. But still, things are trying to kind of slow me down. This place reminds me of the forest that we fought Celsi in, except that it's on a bunch of dead trees. So a couple of the areas in this world represent real places within Geltland, like Linlin and like Flora's bedroom, or one of the rooms in Donwood's castle, maybe. And this place semi-resembles a couple of forests we've been in. I think it was Wendemar Forest, was it not? There are so many forests that I forget. And again, with a nice colorful bubbly background. For the next door, this is actually one of the areas where you can get lost. Because most of the rooms that we've come into, you've just gone through the door you came. You may think that that's actually what you want to do, but it's not. If you do that, you'll be turned around on a complete circle. So what you want to do is you want to go downstairs and you want to try this door. That absolutely caught me off guard. I tried to go through that door I came in through, because I figured that when I come to these dead-end rooms, the only thing I can do is go back. But what I suggest doing is when you come to one of those real-life places, is to first search around the place to see if there is an alternate door. Because if there is, A, you'll be able to go through it, but B, you'll be locked, and you know if there's only one way to go. I think that's about the only place that would throw you off of the main path. And again, here's another one of these checkerboard places with no enemy encounters. They just need a couple of chess pieces in here. It reminds me of a gigantic chessboard of sorts, with the black ones in the background. This place isn't very long, it just feels long because of how many doors you have to go through. And a lot of the time, there's not a whole lot in the area you go through, so you're just walking along, trying to get to the next area. Here we go. Hey, it's a photo. I'm actually going to find a person here. I've been waiting for you. This is the very last place where someone might come to your aid. From this point on, no one will be able to help you. So will you rest now? What do you say? Okay, so this is your single save space that you get over here in Mammoth's World. I had mentioned that when we met with Leonardo, that was the last save point. But more what I meant was it was the last save point before the point of no return. And from Leonardo, you have to fight King Glengus and come into Mammoth's World to find a photo. So this is kind of your save point before the final boss. And once you spoke with her and saved up, go ahead and get back up before you came. Now, it's been a while since we've been here. You guys remember the moment of such time, dear. So here you might get a little bit lost, you might try to go through the doors to see where you need to go next, because there are a lot of doors. So just to save you all some time, the only door that's open will be the one going towards the monastery. If I can find it, of course. It's this way, I believe. And this should actually be our final door before we can go see them, so they too.
Okay. I'm an idiot. Yeah. I had to look it up, but I figured it out. Thank God. It's this way. But how can you blame me? How can you blame me? Hold on. All right, here we go. Whoa! Now he looks pretty cool. Oh shit. I guess water is the way to go. I mean, fire is the way to go. Ooh, that one hurt. Alright, time to zap some MP. Let me heal a little bit. Nice. God damn, quit missing. Wait a minute. God damn it! Come on! Oh, come the fuck on! Okay. Quit using that move. Yes. Oh God, don't do this shit to me. Come on. Okay. Nice. And I haven't been missing on him. I gotta steal magic from him. Come on. Yes! Nice. Okay, that's good. Quit! Fuck you! I'm gonna die. No! Thank God. Come on. Thank you. Oh, that was a close one. Oh, fuck. I only used the level one. Nice. Can I see how much health he has left? No, it just shows how much health he has in general. God damn, he's got 2300. I'm doing chip damage to him. Come on. Okay. This is fucking boring. Let's try a water pillar. Oh, it hits him. Okay. Quit it! Quit! I knew it. I'm probably better off doing fireball because at least some of them hit him every time. It's not a full miss. I think it does more damage if all of them hit him anyway. God damn it! Enough with that move. Holy shit! Yes! Peace.
That's it?
We didn't get a scene with our father? Isn't that what this whole game was about? Finding our father? Okay, well, I guess that's Quest 64. I guess my thoughts on the game are pretty much what I've been saying the whole time. It's a very generic, mediocre RPG. Very short, and it seemed like very rushed. Especially near the end. It was over before I even knew it, before I even, like, I did not expect it to end as when it did. I expected at least, like, another 10 more hours, at least. But, that's, Quest 64. There's never a sequel to this game, obviously. I don't know how well it did. The graphics were nice. For N64, the graphics were nice. The story was really, I don't know, nothing. It was a nothing story. It's just, you know, there's always somebody to say, just replace a princess with your father. And again, you don't really get any closure with that. It didn't say anything about your father at the end. Even though this whole game was meant to be about saving your father. I didn't talk a lot this playthrough because it was really boring. And I really wanted the game to be over with. Pretty much, like, 5 hours in, I was ready for this game to be over with. But it's not a bad game. That's the question I was asking the whole time. I've always heard about this game, and it doesn't have a good reputation. I just wanted to see for myself. I thought it might be a hidden gem. But, it wasn't. It's just another mediocre RPG. I'd rather play Shin Megami Tensei, Nocturne, or Strange Journey, or hell, even though I'm not a Final Fantasy guy, but I'd rather play Final Fantasy than this. The music sucked. The music right now that I'm listening to sucks. It's just like, it sounds like, if you ever mess around in RPG Maker, it sounds like RPG Maker stock music. But yeah, that's it. I'm just kind of talking now to get through the credits, but let me see if I can skip them. No, I cannot, of course. Why would I be able to? Anyway, I'm going to not... Well, that took a little longer than I expected. I expected it only to be like 10 more minutes, but I did get lost at the beginning and had to look it up, where to go. I only died once this entire playthrough. And that's because I didn't know I had this steel magic spell. I would have been fucked without that spell. And without the healing spell, I would have been fucked. This game would have been impossible. Because there's no currency system where you can buy healing potions and stuff like that. You have to either have it given to you or find it. Or get a drop from an enemy, which is very rare. I think it only happened like less than 10 times I got a drop from an enemy. But yeah, if you wanna, if you've never had played an RPG before, and you want like something really simple, I guess I would recommend this game to you. But even then, I would rather just recommend like Pokemon as your first RPG.
rather than this. I don't even know who to recommend this game to. I don't know. Anyway, I guess that's it. Let's see if anything happens after the credits. Maybe we do get to sing with the father. No, we don't. The game ends. Well, I guess that's it for Quest 64. I will be back with my next game. Maybe this weekend? Probably this weekend, yeah. I do have something going on, but it'll probably be a later stream, Friday. It won't be an early day stream. Early, like, mid-afternoon. It won't be an afternoon stream, it'll be an evening stream. But I will stream Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. And it'll be my next game, which will be a good game. So, anyway, I'm looking forward to that. Anyway, thank you for watching. And I will see you guys later.